Good morning.
Digital chorus, a digital reverb and delay.
One, two, one. You switch this one up. Graham, can you put the lectern up a wee bit? One, two, right.
Right, I thought back then actually, I started the emotion for 61 next month. Yes, 40 years. Let's go. special pipes, not those ones, the pipe ones that give so much keywords. And I used to, any concert I have, I did to their pipes, here's more of them than it was, they did a concert.
Good morning. Lovely to see so many of you here today, and a welcome to those who are joining online as well. Nice to see you as we come and share together. We're going to use this song to finish, and I don't remember singing it for a good number of years. So we're going to do a quick run through of first verse and chorus so that when we come to sing it at the end, you've at least got some kind of idea. You'll at least be able to join in with the words at the start because they're just, is it nanas, Craig?
Well, what I do now is, when I used to do this with Graham, how long ago was it?
It doesn't matter.
A wee while ago now. Before he came here, we had a keyboard player who was just phenomenal. And he played this piano part, and I just liked the sound of the piano part, so I just sing it now. And it kind of goes like that. Na, and key would be good. Na, 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 na. How is that? Are we going to have a go at it? And then you need to clap and do bits as well. Are we ready? Na, 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 and again, na. Once your mouths are working, we can get our hands clapping. Yeah, maybe. Do you want to lead it? Clappity, clappity. Here we go. Na 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 na. One more time. Na 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 na. Wherever it goes, through the valleys and over the fields, the river is rushing and the river is dear. Oh, the river of God said, you be the dancing. River of God fills your heart with cheer. River of God fills your mouth with laughter. We rejoice for the river is here. Na 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 na. Let me hear you. Na 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 again. Na.
Save the rest for later.
Awesome.
So I'm going to come back to that.
Thank you.
Yes. So as by way of a welcome to Craig, who's leading our worship today, really pleased that you're with us and able to join us. So you can look forward to that at the end of the service. And we're going to finish on that song. Just one or two things to say just as we start today. So if you hit one and then... Okay, annual stated meeting will be after the service today. Do go next door, get a coffee. We'll take about 15, 20 minutes and then start the meeting. So annual stated meeting after the service today, but do go and get yourselves a tea or a coffee. Next week is our communion service, and at the last meeting of the board and the session, we agreed that we're going to have communion on the first Sunday of each month. So not just quarterly, but on the first Sunday of each month, we're now able to distribute the elements and things much more easily. And so we're going to do communion on the first Sunday of each month. And that will be, this is the first one that we would usually have anyway. Just pre-warning, the summer services, they'll continue at 10:30. The first four Sundays of July will have a more traditional format. And then from the last Sunday of July, it's a five-Sunday month, from the last Sunday of July, we will do family services until the end of the school holidays. So just to let you know about that as we approach the summer. Afternoon teas, we are hosting a number of those over the next 3 weeks. What's the age limit, Mary?
I think it's
I'm too young, I know that. Okay, so over 80, I know there are a few under 80s getting in. If you're over 80 and you haven't had an invitation, please say to me this morning or say to Mary this morning, because we would love to have you along. Okay, we don't want to miss anyone out, so we're doing afternoon tea starting this week, and then there's 3 weeks worth. We're doing it in smaller numbers rather than everybody together, so about 20 or 30 at a time, and those start this week. Please do let me know if there's anybody that we've missed out, because we don't want to miss folk out. And apologies if you're thinking, I'm only 78 and they've invited me. Just accept the invitation and come along and enjoy it. Finally, to say the small groups are continuing to look at this material by John Eldridge, Get Your Life Back. If you would like to look at that material yourself, there's a set of videos that I can give you access to online. So if you want to do that, then please speak to me and I'll give you an access code to go and to view those. And if you still want to join a group, there are groups meeting on Sunday mornings, on Tuesday mornings, on evenings, Thursday evenings, different groups on the go. So do let me know if you'd like to join one of those groups. That is all that I've got to say at the start. We're going to sing three songs of worship together just now, back to back. So please, if you're able to stand, then please do stand as we sing these together. Bless the Lord, O my soul, strength will rise, and then blessed be the name of the Lord. Thank you.
streams are abundant, flow, blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. Blessed be your name when the sun's shining down on me, when the world's all as it should be. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name on the road marked with suffering, though there's pain in the offering. Blessed be your name. Every blessing you pour out, I'll turn back to grace. When the darkness closes in, Lord, still I will say, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. Will you give and you take away? Lord, you give and you take away. But my heart will choose to say, Lord, blessed be your name. I said you give and you take away. Lord, you give and you take away.
Let's pray together, shall we? Lord, we sing, blessed be your name. And as we come into this place today, so we seek to honour you, our Lord and our God. Stop us in this place, we pray, that we may know your presence and that we may honour your name. For we ask it in Jesus. Amen.
Good morning. Now, I'm going to need a volunteer, well, maybe a victim, actually, maybe. Right, Hannah, up you come then. Hannah, put her hand up straight away. I was going to pick on an adult, but as soon as your hand's gone up straight away, come up with me. Right then, I've got a very simple task for you. You are going to be blindfolded, so Could you blindfold Hannah for me, please? Take your glasses off. You don't. That's it. Grand. Good job. That's why I said I needed a volunteer slash victim, you see. So, follow me. That's it. Right, you're now facing everyone, all right? So, I've got a simple task for you to do blindfolded. I've got some eggs, and I need you to get them into this bucket here without smashing them. All right? On you go then.
Where are the eggs?
I don't know where the eggs are. There's the bowl. Well, I don't have the eggs, but would you like me to give you an egg?
Yes, please.
You would like me to give you an egg. Okay, right. In your hand, nice and gently.
Break it. Right. Now you're going to put the egg into the bowl, but I don't want you to break the egg. Don't want you to break the egg. So you'd like me to help you with that?
Yes, please.
Okay, so break the egg. There we go. You've got one in. You've still got another one. Put it in. Where did I put the egg? Would you like me to give you the egg? So it was a relatively simple task, but you needed some help, didn't you? And you were able to ask me for some help. And sometimes in life, we need a little bit of help, don't we? So thank you very much, Hannah. So we continue on with the show. We are going to play a little bit of a pairs game. So I should have 12 boxes up there, so I've learnt a new skill this week on PowerPoint and how to play pairs and make things disappear and come back again. So I've been watching YouTube videos on how to do that, so I know how to do that, so I'm an expert on that. So what we're going to do is we're going to do this side versus this side. So pick two numbers, and if the two things match, so it's going to be someone or something that helps someone or something do something else. So who would like to pick a number from this side first? Anyone want to pick a number? Number nine. Can we have number nine, please? And hopefully this works, you see. So we've got a boat. Okay, then, pick another number. Somebody else from this side. Number one. So we have a boat and we have a broken down car. Don't think that's quite a pair, but remember where they are because that might be important. Okay, then, somebody from this side, pick a number. Number two. Thank you, Xander. Number two. Okay, so we've got someone at the dentist. Right, pick another. Right, Kieran, you got a number? Number eight, let's pick number eight. Ah, lollipop person, that's not going to help you. That's not going to help you. Okay then, back to this side. Have we got someone who wants to pick a number? Hannah, go for it. Number six. Oh, we've got someone who's waiting to cross the road. Maybe got a bit of a clue. Go on then. Number eight. Okay then, there we go. So we've got a point to this side. Well done. Well done. Right then, back over to this side. Eden, did you have a number? Number four, please. Oh, so we've got someone who's maybe got a bit of a spanner. Number one, let's see if you're right. Oh, we've pulled it. That's it. 1-0. So somebody that can maybe fix your car. Good job. Okay, then back to this side. Have we got somebody that wants to pick a number? Just shout it out if you don't want to put your hat. Number 10. Okay, we've got some pets there. A cat, a dog. Another number? Number 12. No, not quite. So we've got a lighthouse there. So back to this side. What number? What was that number?
Nine.
Number nine. Okay, what do we think that goes with? Number 12. Okay, then let's see. Oh, there we go. So, yep, a boat and a lighthouse to try and help you if you're going to, so you don't crash into the land, I suppose. All right, then. So 2-1. Back to this side. What have we got? A number? Number three. Okay, so we've maybe got a nurse here. Go on then, Isaac. Yep. Number two. No, not quite a pair, not quite a pair. You will see that later on when you see the pictures. Right, back to this side. Number five. Okay, we've got someone who's maybe a little bit unwell. We've maybe got a pair that... Go on then, Finn. Number three. Yep, so we've got a nurse and someone who's unwell. So what's that score? 3-1. Oh, come on this side. We need to get one here. We need to get one here. Okay then, who's picking a number? Number seven. Oh, we've got somebody with a little bit of toothache. What number? Number two. Good job. And by default, this side, what number are we going to go for? 10 and 11. Hopefully that's going to be a vet, someone to look after. So congratulations to this side. You beat this side 4-2, I think the score was in the end. So lots of things where we might need help. So whether your pet's unwell or things like your car's broken down, you need someone to help you. Today we're looking a little bit about a promise that Jesus gave us, that he was going to send us a helper. So it wasn't someone to come and fix our car, but actually Jesus was going to send us the Holy Spirit, who was going to be a helper for us.
So yes, here's the question then is, who is our helper? Now, are we actually having the reading as part of it, or are we? No, okay. So the question is, who is our helper? And we absolutely, just as Alan was saying, we need people to help us. We need situations that will help us. So the question is, who is our helper? And I'd like you to have a listen out for who we hear. Alan's already used the words, but if you have a listen out for who we hear is able to help us to live for Jesus in this video that we're about to watch.
Jesus told his disciples that he did all the things that God had told everyone that he would do, and the disciples understood what he was saying.
Yep, that makes sense.
He told them that he would send the Holy Spirit, just as God had promised to be their helper.
Sounds good.
After Jesus had spent 40 days with the disciples and appeared to many people,
hey, that's it.
He led the disciples to a place called Bethany. Jesus blessed the disciples and told them to go out and tell the whole world about him and the good news of forgiveness and make disciples of them. Then he said, "Be sure of this, I am with you always, even to the end of the age." Then Jesus was taken into heaven to sit at the right hand of God. Not long after that, the Holy Spirit did come to the disciples to be their helper. The disciples knew that God would truly be with them always. And the Holy Spirit is still with us today, for Jesus promised that he would be with us to the end of the age, and he is.
So did you hear then that Jesus' promise was and is that the Holy Spirit is here as our helper? And I wonder if you heard too the things that the disciples were asked to go and do, and there are things that we are asked to go and do too. We are asked to take Jesus' message out to other people, to tell other people about Jesus, but we don't have to do it on our own. And that was really important, because I wonder if you noticed there in the video that we get to a point where Jesus ascends to heaven. Jesus goes back to be with God the Father. And it was really important that he was able to say, but I'm not leaving you on your own. I'm giving you a job to do, but you don't have to do it on your own. The Holy Spirit is here to help you. Now, today is a day called Ascension Sunday, where we think about the time where Jesus went back to be with God the Father. But next week, you'll have seen what happens next. Next week, we are going to be thinking about Pentecost, and that is a time when we celebrate Jesus' promise to send the Holy Spirit coming true. And when we celebrate the Holy Spirit coming, and we know the Holy Spirit with us as our helper. So why don't we close our eyes just for a moment now and pray and say thank you to God for sending us the Holy Spirit. Let's pray, and I'll say a line and you can repeat a line after me. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, thank you for promising to send the Holy Spirit. Lord Jesus, thank you for promising to send the Holy Spirit. And Holy Spirit, thank you that you are our helper. Holy Spirit, thank you that you are our helper. Please show us how to live for Jesus today and every day. Please show us how to live for Jesus today and every day. Amen. We are going to sing again now, and we're going to sing about that promise that Jesus gives us, that he will be with us always by the Holy Spirit, and we're going to sing Jesus and Me. That's the best combination.
Youngsters are going to have some activities to do over the next wee while, and Alan's going to come and explain to them what they've got.
So this morning I thought we could make a little bit something to remind us a little bit about the Holy Spirit. Now, although we can't see the Holy Spirit, we can usually see its effects. So I thought we could make a little bit of a windmill slash pinwheel. So there'll be some things for you to come and make this. So bits of card to come and decorate, and then hopefully you'll be able to put a pin through it and make a bit of a kind of windmill. So during the next song, if you come up and get some of the bits and pieces from over here, and there's instructions there, and you'll be staying in here to decorate them and stuff like that. All right.
Okay, so do come and get the stuff from the side. If you want to go and sit with somebody else while you're making those or whatever, if you want to sit with some other folk your age, then feel free to do that. But while we're singing our next song, do come and get the bits and pieces that you'll need just from the side. We're going to sing Amazing Grace, How Sweet the Sound.
Was lost.
So we sing of the love that God has for us, the love he has shown in Jesus. Amazing grace. How sweet the sound. And of course, those who were around Jesus, his disciples, the apostles, the women who were there, who'd seen the empty tomb, they knew that amazing grace too and knew that they were to share it. And over the last few weeks, we've been studying together Acts of the Apostles, just taking some time to look together at some of what happened in the early church. There's an interesting introduction to it just in the Good News Bible. Here's what it says about Acts of the Apostles. The Acts of the Apostles is a continuation of Luke. Its chief purpose is to tell how Jesus' early followers, led by the Holy Spirit, spread the good news about him in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. It's the story of the Christian movement as it began among the Jewish people and went on to become a faith for the whole world. A faith for the whole world. And what we read in Acts of the Apostles is the starting of that. And today we're turning the clock right back to the very first verses of Acts. So let's read that together from Acts chapter 1 as Luke writes for us. It says, in my first book, I wrote about all the things that Jesus did and taught from the time he began his work until the day he was taken up to heaven. Before he was taken up, he gave instructions by the power of the Holy Spirit to the men he had chosen as his apostles. For 40 days after his death, he appeared to them many times in ways that proved beyond doubt that he was alive. They saw him. And he talked with them about the kingdom of God. And when they came together, he gave them this order. Do not leave Jerusalem, but wait for the gift I told you about, the gift my Father promised. John baptized with water, but in a few days, you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When the apostles met together with Jesus, they asked him, Lord, will you at this time give the kingdom back to Israel? Jesus said to them, the times and occasions are set by my Father's own authority, and it's not for you to know when they will be. But when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, you will be filled with power, and you will be witnesses for me in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. After saying this, he was taken up to heaven as they watched him, and a cloud hid him from their sight. Amen. A wonderful start to Luke's second book. We might call Luke's gospel the Acts of Jesus, and then the second book is the Acts of the Apostles. And there are two things that are striking for me. The first one is this: the way that Luke highlights the activity of the Holy Spirit. All the way through these early verses, verse 2, verse 5, and verse 6. Even in that point where Jesus shares with his disciples, it is by the power of the Holy Spirit Jesus shared with his disciples. And there's a sense in which Luke wants us to catch right at the beginning that without the Holy Spirit, what follows would not have happened. Without the Holy Spirit, what follows would not have happened. All the things we've looked at over the last 2 or 3 weeks would not have happened. But here's the thing. Nor would have what had gone before. And there's an interesting parallel between the way that he starts his gospel and the way that he starts Acts of the Apostles. In Luke chapter 3, we read of the baptism of Jesus, and it says this: after all the people had been baptized, Jesus also was baptized. While he was praying, heaven was opened, and the Holy Spirit came down upon him, that's Jesus, in bodily form like a dove. Before Jesus starts his ministry, he is baptized and he is filled with the Holy Spirit. It is the Holy Spirit who empowers and enables Jesus in his ministry. And when we come to Acts of the Apostles, it's the Holy Spirit who enables the apostles and the others to do the work that Jesus has given them. Here is the one who will eventually give us the Holy Spirit, who himself is filled with. In that passage, John, speaking of the coming of Jesus, says, I baptize you with water, but someone is coming who is much greater than I am. I'm not good enough even to untie his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. And so as Jesus was filled with the Holy Spirit and ministered in the power of the Spirit, so did the early church. And so can, or so must, we. If we ever imagine that the work that we have been given to do, we can do in our own strength and in our own power, we've got it wrong. We are to be a holy people enabled by the Holy Spirit. A holy people enabled by the Holy Spirit. So, that focus on the Holy Spirit. The second thing was this word, wait. Wait. Have a look at these pictures. Have a chat with folk next to you. Which of these catch how you feel about waiting? Have a chat with folk next to you. Okay, anybody like waiting? Let me tell you a little story. Jane and I are waiting on a new bed. Right, we ordered it 8 weeks ago, and the guy told us it would take 10 days. It came 4.5 weeks ago. So I took apart the bed that we've got. Yeah, didn't bother that I was maybe breaking some stuff on the way. Got the new bed out and discovered that a bit of the new bed was broken. So a bit of my bed had to be returned That was 3 weeks ago. Am I patiently waiting on the bit of my bed? Or am I on the phone and saying, where's the bit for my bed? I haven't quite said to them, do you know that I'm sleeping in the bed in the spare room and it's only a double? But you can imagine that waiting is not something that I want to do. Waiting is not something that's there. And I guess a lot of the time, if we're waiting at a bus stop or other places, we're thinking about the other things that we could be doing if we weren't waiting. Waiting time feels like wasted time. Largely. It was interesting because I put together this slide and actually chose that picture down the bottom corner, and it's that that has set me off thinking. That actually there are times where we wait, where actually we enjoy the waiting as well as the moment. Doesn't happen very often, perhaps, but there are times where that's true. What happens if you get up early in the morning waiting for a sunrise? Are you champing at the bit, going, come on, sun, hurry up, get in the sky? Or do you actually enjoy the silence of that moment as you wait? It was that that really struck me. I did a reflection for the phone line this morning and took some time to think about that. Said the waiting that the disciples are asked to do is not this fraught, anxious time. It's more like getting up early to wait on the dawn of a new day, sitting, waiting, patiently, enjoying the silence, and there with a sense of anticipation. I can't bring light into the darkness. I can't bring colour into the monochrome of the pre-dawn. Only the sun can do that. And for the sunrise, I wait. Nothing I can do can force it on. In its own time, it comes. And so it is for the early disciples, called to wait on the coming of the Holy Spirit, the one who will empower them and enable them to fulfil the call upon their lives. To carry on the work of Jesus, not in their own strength, but in his. And because God is at work in them and through them. And the time of waiting is a time for them to get their heads round that. Not only the great calling that is placed on them, but the weakness that is theirs. The inability to fulfill that calling without the Holy Spirit. They sit in the pre-dawn. But they do so with the expectation of the coming dawn of the new day that will burst forth when the Holy Spirit comes. And so it should be for us. In the church, as we celebrate today Ascension Sunday, and as we look forward to next week being the week of Pentecost, we sit almost waiting in that pre-dawn period, waiting for the rising of the sun, waiting for the coming of the Holy Spirit. Reminded that without the Holy Spirit, we will never have all that we need. Never. Not in our strength, but in his. And so perhaps this week we need to sit with those early disciples in the pre-dawn and recall that we too need the empowering of the Holy Spirit. Luke tells us that they gathered together frequently to pray as a group, together with the women and Mary, the mother of Jesus, and with his brothers. This book, which is all about activity and action, begins in waiting and prayer. Shall we pray together? Lord, forgive us because so often we imagine that we can do things in our own strength and fail to take the time to wait and pray. As we see the way that the early disciples did that, may we do that too. May we wait on you. May it be like sitting, waiting on the sunrise, that there would be in us an expectation that we would see you at work among us as we wait on you. For as you promised the Holy Spirit to them, so your promise is also for us. Lord, may we sit in that truth this week, that as we come next Sunday and celebrate Pentecost, that we might truly celebrate the coming of the Holy Spirit, the empowerer, the enabler, the helper. Amen. Be still, for the presence of the Lord, the Holy One, is here. Two things I forgot to say at the start. One was a thank you to everybody who helped with Christian Aid concert and gave money to Christian Aid over the last week or so. The amount raised so far is £710.22, which is great. So if you still want to contribute to that, there's still time, but marvellous that we've been able to contribute to that just over the last couple of weeks. The second thing to say is that there is a praise night for all of the Church of Scotland in Midlothian. It's not this coming Saturday, but a week on Saturday at 7 o'clock in Pennycook Trinity Community Church. What was St Mungo's, which is now a union of South, and St Mungo's is now Pennycook Trinity Community Church. So 7 o'clock, a week on Saturday. If you want to join us, you'll be very welcome at that. That's on the 11th. Okay, have you got any of your things ready to come up and show us? Kieran, you're going to come up and show us what you've made? Yeah. Come on in. Up you come. Well done. Look at yours. They are so colourful. Really, really nice. What would make them move? Any ideas what would make them move? Wind. That's right. Wind would make them move. And wind is one of the signs of the Holy Spirit. Sometimes the Holy Spirit is described as the wind or the breath of God. And that's why you've got these. Because when the Holy Spirit comes, it was like a wind in the place where the people were. So we're looking forward to that next week. You can bring them back with you next week if you remember, because we'll be thinking about the coming of the Holy Spirit. You've got high heels on. There you go. Do you want to go back and sit down just now? Well done. Give them a big clap. Well done. And our final song this morning, you know from earlier on, it is a reminder of what the Holy Spirit brings. And although we celebrate Pentecost next week, there's that sense of anticipation even this week. Down the mountain, the river flows.
I've always loved this song for lots and lots of reasons. One, it's good fun to play. But it's always, just like Graham was saying, today's service has been about the Holy Spirit. Is for me, the river of God sets your feet are dancing. It's the Holy Spirit that sets your feet are dancing. And that's what the song's saying. And it just, it makes me want to kind of dance when I'm playing. I'm about the most graceful gadget you'll ever see in the world. Graceless is what I am. However, I just want to dance when I play this song and sing this song. So if you want to move about and enjoy it, then please, please do it and clap away.
As we go this day, may we know your presence. May your presence flood us. May we go in the power of your Holy Spirit. And may the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with each one of you this day and forevermore.
Amen. Please be seated. Can we say thank you to our musicians for helping to lead our worship this morning? And just a reminder that we have our annual stated meeting. Do go next door, have a coffee. Be about 1:45 before we start. So do go and get a tea and coffee, and then we'll start the meeting about 1:45.